Skip Good from the Coin Chaplet, the infamous Bobby Lee, the first year at Cataldo.
And our infamous Ballet Ball, this is super cool.
Yeah. So, Bobby, thank you for taking the time to meet with us today. Great on stage.
Thank you.
Very exciting. I guess the first question for me really is, what got you excited about setting up the Ballet Ball and getting the whole...
It's almost a year long now. Right. A year ago, I came up with a mission that I really wanted to create a solution that was good for people. We don't want custodial service. I don't want to be custodial anymore. There's so much of a shame. I'm out of the custodial business. I want users to hold it and make a phone. But how to give it to them in a very safe way?
Yeah.
So finally, in December last year, I thought of this idea. And in January, so next week, I have a whole team. And together, I'll be doing a whole It's very different because what we have here is a non-electronic device. So there's no chips or electronics on the board. That means it has longevity, it's built to last. It's used for long-term economy, long-term investment, and it's for cryptocurrencies. So you can build for Ethereum. So really allows normal people to have their cryptocurrency, have their private keys in their own hands without relying on custodial service, without relying on the exchange, without relying on me. Once they have this product, just a little bit put under here. There's no setup. There's no administration. There's no usernames. There's no passwords.
Quick question for you. So, like, when I have my like credit cards, I always go around with one of these little plastic, secure ID anti-theft. Do people that have a Ballet Wallet need to be worried about potential hacking by way of?
No. It's on here. There's also the passphrase. Everything's self-contained. It's temporary. So that until you peel the sticker, you scratch it off. It's secure and it's secure. You can store it in a safe. You're not terrible if you can control the safe.
Which is the irony, right? You can put it in the bank vault.
If you want to.
I know, but I mean, we're trying to get out of the whole custodial and banking, and we're going to stick it in.
Sure. Some people put it at home, they have a nice safe at home.
Sure.
Find someone in the fridge, like a house. You can spread it out. You can have multiple things. You can spread out all the friends and relatives.
So just to pivot to something a little different, you were in CC London, right?
Yes, that's right.
That was an amazing debate. I was wondering, do you and Nouriel Roubini have some sort of history?
Because,
you know, I was watching the questions you were asking, they were pretty reasonable, normal questions.
Yeah.
And he was just like, I'm going to fight you on this. He was like, no, I'm not answering this question. Like, what's going on with the guy?
Real question.
About that.
Economists probably don't feel comfortable answering. So there's comfortable truths about money today.
Yeah.
Which is a printing, the fact it's based on debt, the passive, the fact it's not asset based, the fact it's limited to printing, all that stuff needed.
That was really, it was intense. I've never seen him so. And it was just you that he was targeting on stage. And I don't understand. It seems like there was like some sort of. It came across like there was bad blood, to be honest. I didn't think there was, but he was so aggressive with you. I thought it's unnecessary the way he was behaving. So, then the whole changing of money certainly is leading to that kind of thing.
I think we're doing more pressure. I think the existing system, there's a lot of pressure on the existing system. There's going to be able to realize that the fiat money system is not
It is. It's
good monopoly. That's why the price of people are
I really haven't even that long on it.
I should carry that in the future.
Find on the flight over here, you've been writing these experience
with the I just saw that. I was such a surprise. I was in Los Angeles Airport. He and his family traveled to a location. They boarded from a special airport, so they came on very last. So they were like, I can't see them. And then they all showed up.
Did your heart start beating fast? The plane's going down. It's going to be a terrorist on the plane.
So it was like amazing. He was sitting right next to me across the aisle. I was like, exactly. And then finally, a flight attendant was asking for his meal preference. She called him Mr. Willis. I'm like, aha, that's
Bruce. Nice.
So that's when I went to say hi and introduce me.
Excellent.
I was able to give him his two daughters.
fantastic. Very cool. So what's the, so let's move back to Ballet for a second, because I know we're short on time.
Yeah.
What's the direction you see where Ballet is going? What's the goal in terms of adoption and how do we get out there?
The goal is really to bring Bitcoin to everyday use. Yeah. I think Bitcoin is too hard. It's very hard to buy. Our last company that sold the bond on the exchange that I've never buy easy. That was a really thing. It's just kind of how to score Bitcoin on a global basis. So we are now has to be 8 or 9 languages. It's a global product. It's made in the USA, but we ship it globally. And we have to sell it over and move it to the And it's really easy, there's no setup. So literally, users all around the world, don't care if you're in a foreign country, you're white collar, blue collar, poor or rich, you can use this. I don't care if you have college education, we call it 9 to 99 years old.
Sounds like our book.
Yeah, it's great. Like everyone.
Yeah.
Grandmothers and grandfathers.
That's right.
My grandfather's 95. This is a lot of the
economies. Yeah. Well, it's interesting. We'll have to talk about that separately because we've got our book coming out. Yeah. Fine. It's basically your grandmother's guide to starting a cryptocurrency.
Exactly.
So
we think this is
our target audience and your target wallet. So that's great. So if people want to get access to sign up for our Ballet wallet,
go to the website ballycrypto.com.
Ballycrypto.com?
Yeah.
Great.
And then there's a very nice layout of pages describing how the wallet works.
Awesome.
There's sections catering to the new people, there's sections catering to the e-signature, and we all the safety aspects of the
technology.
Excellent.
We'll put a link down below for the episode for anybody who's watching this and wants to get access to a Ballet wallet, of course.
Okay, one last question.
Yeah.
Why Ballet?
The name. Well, it's a really nice name. It's a very pretty, elegant, simple name.
Yeah.
We want to target the mass market. We want to find a name that is really female friendly.
Sure.
Something that's not geeky. All the names, to be honest, all the names.
I know. Crypto is something.
They're very,
All you'll lose. Our show is called The Coin Chappie. And Yuri always jokes, thank God we don't call ourselves The Crypto something. Because everyone's called The Crypto something.
Yeah, exactly. So one name that's very simple. And also the name that's not taken.
Right.
All the crypto fintech names are all taken.
Yeah.
There's a lot of companies with the same names too. So Ballet is way out there.
Right? It is, yeah.
So it's really simple.
And it's more graceful and elegant.
Exactly.
Stylish.
Yeah. I come from the theater space. I was like instantly like, yes, Ballet, well, that's something I want to learn more about.
Exactly.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Thank you, Bob. It's great to meet you. Yeah.
Thank you, Steve.
And, if you want to check out the Ballet wallet, it's ballywallet.com. Put the links down below for everybody. And, Bobby, thank you very much for the time.
Take care.